If you're anything like me, after you wake up and do your morning routine, the next thing you do is you check your stocks. I start my day off with checking my Fundrise account. You may wonder, why do you check Fundrise? If in all your previous videos you say that it's a long-term investment, you just put your money in and you forget about it for 5 to 10 years. Well, that's true. However, Fundrise tries to keep things interested by paying out their dividends, not on a quarterly basis like most other traditional stocks, but instead they take small portions of the total dividends you would earn quarterly and pay them out daily. Now, what do these dividends actually mean? Coming up. If you're new to the channel, my name is Trey, and I'm a stock, crypto, and real estate investor and a swing trader. If you enjoyed this video, please click that like and subscribe button, and don't forget to check out my entire Fundrise playlist up here and down in the description below. Now, let's get started. Now, first things first, if you are investing with Fundrise, you will be getting a certain portion of your returns in dividends. It doesn't matter what kind of portfolio you have, the basic or the advanced portfolio. It doesn't matter what investment plan you have, the supplemental income or the long-term growth. Everyone will get some sort of dividend return. If you choose supplemental income or balanced investing, you will get more of your return in dividends than if you were to choose long-term growth. The second thing is that no matter what, you and I will have to pay taxes on our dividend profits from Fundrise. Dividends are taxed as ordinary income. So if you're in a higher income tax bracket, such as 28, 30, or 33%, you will be paying higher taxes on your dividend income. That is why I suggest choosing a long-term growth investment plan, because with this investment plan, your total return from dividends will be much smaller and most of your returns will be from appreciation. Appreciation gets taxed as capital gains, which means you will only be paying 15 to 20% taxes when you decide to sell certain shares of your E-REITs and E-funds. After you receive your dividends, you have to make a choice. You either take these dividends and you put them into your bank account, or you decide to reinvest it. And reinvesting dividends in Fundrise is very, very easy. You just go to the settings and there's going to be a tab there that says dividend reinvestment, and you just have to click it on. Even though Fundrise pays you dividends every single day to keep things interesting and to keep you coming back, checking out the platform or the app on the phone, they only get reinvested once every 3 months. And it's usually around middle of April, middle of June, middle of October, and middle of January of next year. When dividends get reinvested, they're put back into the Fundrise platform, and then they get split into different E-REITs and E-funds that Fundrise offers. Now, this is a sort of compounding. That is why I suggest for anybody who is investing with Fundrise to, again, choose long-term growth investment plan and then reinvest your dividends. This is compounding at its best. I know it seems little at first. It might be $50 every 3 months that get reinvested, but over 5, 10, 15, 20 years time, you will see how this compounding will add up to crazy amounts of money, and you will see your returns grow exponentially. So the best practices for Fundrise is to choose long-term growth investment plan and reinvest your dividends. This way, you get to save both on taxes, as you will only pay capital gains tax when you decide finally to sell your shares of E-REITs and E-funds, and as well as benefit from direct compounding of dividends that you accrue daily and which get reinvested on a quarterly basis. Now guys, in order to demonstrate this, I actually haven't logged into my Fundrise account for about 3 to 4 days. So I want to show you what my screen looks like when I finally log in. I want to show you how much daily dividend return I get, and how every 3 months or quarterly, how these dividends can get reinvested. Now let's take a look. So I have finally logged into my Fundrise account. As you can see in the upper left corner here, is that my account value increased by about $10.20. Now, if you divide that by about 4, that's around $2.50 a day. So that is how much dividend return I get on a daily basis. However, that money is just sitting there, not earning me any interest for about 90 days or so. Once the quarter ends at around January 15th of 2022, all that dividend income will get pulled together and will get reinvested back into Fundrise, therefore allowing for me to earn new dividends and new interest on these profits. And as you can see here, on October 12th, 2021, I got a notification saying that your third quarter 2021 dividends of $225.89 actually got reinvested. So if we can click on view transactions here, over here it says that $225 on October 13th, my third quarter dividends got reinvested, and it tells you where it gets reinvested. So as you could see, this one was put into the East Coast E-REIT, which is pretty exciting for me to have that, because Fundrise actually sponsors a lot of projects close by to where I live, and I can actually see these crazy rental properties just popping up like mushrooms all over the place. And it's really cool to know that I'm invested with the platform that's actually sponsoring these big projects. So as you could see, I was able, with these dividends, I was able to buy 16 and a half shares of this East Coast E-REIT for an average price of $13.68. Now, this E-REIT share can go up in price, which it has been for the past 2 years. So not only are you earning compound interest on the dividends that you are reinvesting, but you're also benefiting because you're buying shares and these shares increase in price over time. And this directly causes your appreciation to go up as well long term. So as you can see how these little things all add up together, and ultimately you will have a great long-term return if you choose long-term growth investment plan, reinvest your dividends, and stay long-term for at least 5 to 10 years. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, click that like and subscribe button. I would greatly appreciate it. Check out my entire Fundrise playlist down in the description below. And thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.